Meyer with a challenge this morning. Take me deeper.
Most of us in assembly time, we want to settle down. I said, no, you know. That's what we look for in our life. We go to a point in our life where we say, oh, hey, yeah, you know, I want to get to a point in my life where I can say, oh, hey, yeah, problem, settle down, good now, done. Which is really an irony, because that doesn't ever really happen. Ecclesiastes chapter 1 and 2, Solomon, supposedly the most fulfilled man, the greatest king, the greatest kingdom that's ever existed, was never satisfied. Until eventually, at the end of his life in Ecclesiastes, Matanganasa, he's old, by that time he said, I have searched everything I need to search. Look everywhere, you know, above and under the sun, everywhere I could look. Something I've tried everything, discovered everything, and all of them has come to naught or vain. Sayang yan. Nasira yan. It's just destroyed. It's just messed up. That's what Solomon said. What a tragedy that is, that when you come to the end of your life, all the things that you have worked for, all the things you have decided that will be the core values of your home, pag malapit ka na mamatay, you look back and you say, wow, sila yung pala natin kakataon ko. I just messed up everything. You know, after you've tried everything that you need to try, then everything you've done, and at the end of it all, you said, wow, parang, nagsend na ako yung effort. No, inubos ko lang yung pera last week, Hugh Hefner died. No? If you don't know who Hugh Hefner is, he's the founder of Playboy. No? Playboy. And he died. He died. He died with the desire to surround himself and exploit the most beautiful women he could lay his hands on and surround him with it. No? To some people, he was a front runner for, free speech and freedom of the press, you know. Yeah, right. So anyway, so he did it. And at the end of his life, guess what? He died alone. He died alone. After you have spent your entire life in fortune. I read an article written by one of his children. What a terrible thing this is. You know, what a terrible way to... Wow! Inubos mo yung buong buhay mo, pinagkagugol mong lahat dun sa mga bagay that you think is important, only to find at the end of your life, when you come to the end of everything, you've wasted everything. Crazy! Crazy! And when I read that, I was in my office and I read it, and in our school, it is National History Month. So we had an awesome time, you know, having people, important people in history, people who made an impact in a negative or positive way. So yung mga teachers namin, nagpo-costume sila, and they try to be character. So we have a lot of fun in our school, but when that did it, you have friend, I know how easy ako. And then I went down from my office, because I'm on the second floor, and I went down from my office, and I saw that people were putting together, exhibits. Exhibit ng mga old cameras, old paper. I felt really old kasi I saw a 10 peso bill and a 5 peso bill. I was like, oh, I remember when I used to use a 5 peso bill. Sabi naman ako, Dad, parang ba yun ang mga Kastila? Gusto ko yung patawag yung magulang eh, kaso ako dito eh, for disrespectful behavior, di ba? I mean, and I was like, what was going on? Kasi hindi naman ginagawa yun eh. And then what I didn't know was that in the one area, kasi sa school, meron kami isang maliit na room doon, that sort of like a mural for my father. And yung pala yung ginagawa nila, my sister had instructed na gumawa ng, yung lahat ng display, halos lahat, ibaba doon sa baba. No? And right then and there, when I saw that, I heard that about this, you have heard a few articles about his death, etc. I get that. And then I go down, and it was an incredible moment because then, right there in the front of me was the opposite of Hugh Hefner. I saw my father's memorabilia, all the stuff he did for the country, all the stuff he did with the country, all the stuff he did with government, with humanitarian stuff, with all kinds of stuff. His wheelchair, which doesn't embody him, but also of you. Nakita ko lahat ng mga pinagawa niya, and I said to myself while looking at that picture, I said, there goes a guy who died. He did not leave fortunes to his family. He did not die a gazillionaire. But he spent his very last breath chasing after God and trying his best to raise his family. And I said, Yan, that's the value of life. That's the life unwasted. And when he took his last breath, he knew na wala siyang ibang mahuhubuting hininga, na lahat ng hininga niya inubos niya para sa Panginoon. You know, and I looked at that and I said, oh, okay. I was done with that, you know. Which made me rethink about our values, because today we're going to talk about that. Pastor Paul mentioned a statistic that I used last Sunday, and I will keep using them while I'm here. Excuse me for not being here next Sunday. My wife and my two boys, the older boys, will not be here for a few weeks starting next Sunday. So that doesn't mean pwede din kayo mag-absent kasi manunood ako ng street. Patawa ka, kaya ko, church na, wow ka na. You know, but, and I'll be, you know, will be away. I have to do a wedding nung aking bayaw, no? The youngest ng siblings ng mga kapatid na ni Guzman, the only living boy, kasi dalawa lang yan, isa lang sa heaven eh. So I'll be doing a wedding there, and then, yun, nung sabi na ng isang anak ko, Dad, saan pupunta? Sa States na. Saan sa America? Sa California. Doon kayo matutulog? Anak, medyo malayo yun. Sino magta-drive? Ano? Hindi na, sa anak ka meron plano. Buti na lang, malapit lang. California Garden, iniisip niya. Lukod ko dito. Anak ka dito. Medyo malayo yun. Iyo, sana ka ganun lang kalapit. Pero parang, balingan na lang ako para mag-preach. But I won't be here, but you guys, as always, will be an awesome hands of Pastor Paul and the staff who are here. And these gentlemen, I don't have to build them up. They did an awesome job last time. They will keep doing an awesome job. You know, sabi ko ba, I can already die. Not that I want to die, but career-wise and job-wise, pwede na ako mamatay kasi they can do the job already. I have made myself disposable. That's my goal. That's, as a leader, that's my goal, is to make myself disposable. And I think I have almost accomplished that. Humahabol lang si Pastor Paul ng mga dalawang anak pa. Kasi, apat, humahabol sa amin sa dalawa. Tapos, mag-aandap pa siya dalawa pa ulit. So, konti na lang, pre. Mga ilang tao, pwede na ako. Ano. So, but be here as they, and you'll be interested with what they have to say. Kasi, they'll be talking about family, but on their own personal perspective. If you're interested, ano kayong buhay ng mga pastor namin? Anong pinagdaanan nila? Anong mga natutunan na sa buhay nila? Pastor Paul will be here next Sunday and he'll be telling you about gano'ng kahirap mag-asawa ng Koreanan. Kailangan mag-isang prinsip ako yung mga gano'n. Pinagbubuhatan ako ng kamay yung mga gano'n. Parating kong nasa men's health desk. Yung mga gano'n. Nababarangay yung asawa ko. You learn a bunch of stuff from these guys, okay? But today I want to talk to you about climate change. You know, we always said this is the different option of climate change, okay? But see, never have been climate change. What I mean is that lahat ng bagay, ng bahay, lahat ng buhay, lahat ng family ng climate. No, when I enter your house, there's a climate, may weather. There's a weather there. But, oh, okay. Sabi ko, have you, those of you who are here, have you walked in on your parents and paglakad mo sa kwarto na nag-aaway sila? Pero, they don't want you to know na nag-aaway sila. Tama? How about parents, have you walked in on your children and mamay masusuntukan na lang, masusuntukan na sila, and suddenly you walk in their house, suddenly best friend sila? Hindi na mo nag-aaway, anak. Oh, diba? Right? Have you walked? There's a certain climate in our lives and in our homes. Right? The problem is, what sets the climate in our homes, yung nasiset ng climate sa bahay natin, usually is the culture in our home. societal culture that sets the climate in your home. So this is an important series, not only for the sake of your personal life, but also your family life, and even your work life. Yung mga boss ko lang dito. Have you ever had a boss na teron? You will do 100 great things, and he will find 101 wrong things. Have you ever had those? Have you ever had a professor na teron? Hindi ako makakalit. Kasi hindi ako makakalit. Ako pagpating ko lahat ng... Mas na dyan ko, pag nag-resign, sila na mimili ko sa akin gusto na i-resign. They choose. Ang bait, no? Oh, huwag ko lang ako kontra. Ako may ako kontra. Parang Facebook yan. It's my page. My post. Walang bahay naman. Right? Have you ever had those? It's pretty crazy when you have that kind of situation. So, pinag-usapan natin yung change. Now, how do you change the climate? Paano mababaguhin yung klima ng bahay mo? Yung weather sa buhay mo? If you're, there's only one way, kasi otherwise everything is temporary. And that's to change the culture. And I want to challenge you today, okay? Sa lahat ng tao, whether you're a father or a mother, asawa, boss, empleyado, I challenge you today to dare to change the culture of your home by changing, to change the climate, because if you change the climate, you will, culture, you will change the climate. Pag binago mo yung kultura sa loob ng bahay, magbabago din yung weather sa loob ng bahay. No? And we start with the very core of things. And let me explain to you a scary statistic. Itong statistic na to, pakipatayin yung ilan natin para malinaw, ha? Itong statistic na to is pretty scary. If you don't like statistics, you'll get bored. But if you are a father, you will get scared. Okay, let me show you a statistic. I promise you'll have it up there soon. So how will that happen? The statistic says this. Look, it's 71-21. Okay, 7 out of 10 parents have explicit values for the family. Pito sa bawat 10 na magulang, meron kayong sariling core values para sa pamilya. Anong mahalaga? Anong dapat gawin? Ano? Sa bahay namin, pag gumising, everything. May culture tax natin bagay. Pagising sa umaga, lipit mo yung kama. Bawal si LeBron at si Steph Curry sa bahay namin pagdating sa parunihan. You know what I'm talking about? You know when the kids take off their socks? Then they dribble? Oh! 3-2-1! Ay, hindi na shoot. Tapos ako na. Hindi pwede. Kailangan. Iyalin ko yun kasi slam dunk mo sa... When you have that many kids, can you imagine? Just imagine, okay? I have 6 kids. 1 grandkid and 2 more kids. How many are those? 9. Can you imagine sham na brick all over the place? Or 18 socks. Do you get it? When you eat, ibuti ng Christmas, sa isang plato, bring it dun. If you eat, and it's not time to eat, wash your own plate and spoon. More so, we have not just ethical culture, in other words, eat with your fork and spoon, not with your feet. Okay. Core values in the home, okay? Every Saturday night, we have family altar. We pray. We do praises, prayer requests, we read the Bible, we pray. Every Saturday night. Okay? Pag bumas ang pinto ng church, dapat nandun ka. Pag sarado, buksan mo. Okay? Alright. Those are values in our home. The spiritual values in our home are very strong. No? We have, in fact, 4 values when it comes to courtship and marriage. For example, no? Tatatesting natin. Kasi, kaya naman, mabayad yung mga kasi sasama sa akin sa Amerika ko eh. Ito alam kong binata na, Drew! Sige, sige. Hindi natin ko alam niya. Pag may love interest ka, huwag mo kalabit yan. May binabati ka nga sa pagdunigan natin. Pag may love interest ka, all my kids will mimic what he said.
Anong una question?
Kristiyano ba?
Kristiyano ba siya? Second question.
Mas mahal ba si Lord Kinesa?
Mas mahal ba din si Lord Kinesa? Third question. Wala ko siya ito.
Ministry. Ministry. Kaya mahalaga niyo ba?
Right. This the person in 1:7 in ministry. Lastly. Matalino o maganda or whatever. Polos na lang yun. Polos na. And then, pagsagot mo lahat ng apat na yun, anong tulog na tanong mo?
Paalam na sa
magulang. Paalam na sa magulang. Tapos ayos apat. Done! See, remember I said, you ask any of my children, they will have those four values. In that order. In that chronological order. What did you give that pastor? Kasi po, nung una ako nagpapas sa business ko, sabi ng dati, wala, mukhang napupuso ako si Marisa. Opo, dad. You know, I was like, what, 14 years old? 14. I was 14 years old. Nung siya, bibig na siya naman. 14 na ako. Kaka 14, kasi 13 pala ako. I was 13. So, you know, and sabi ng dati, oh, sabi na, naipag-play mo na ngayon? Sabi, tulungan kita mag-play. Siyempre, si Gabino, di ka, hello, kasama mag-play. Diba, astig, diba? Sigurado, sure po na yun. Diba? Kasi si Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Gabino yun. Tusin ko pa rin. So sabi ko, okay, God, so sinasun ka sa prayer ko. So sabi niya, okay, God, so dobro ko, God, God. Parang nagugusto ako po si Marisa. Sabi ko naman ako, parang nagugusto ako po si Marisa. God, na, kung kalooban mo siya, no? Tapay na, secret prayer eh. Kung kalooban mo siya, kung kalooban mo siya, ilapit mo siya sa akin. Ha? Game? Eh, siyempre makainit, inapin mo siya na. Pero kung hindi mo kalooban, nag-isig ako. Alam, pero kung hindi mo kalooban, alisin mo, God! Alisin mo, ang pagkakagusto, God! Ang pagkakagusto, ko sa kanya. Huwag na gala. Diba? Buti na lang ako, napikot ako. Kaya napilin. Otherwise, diba? Ipakilalak namin, hindi ko alam paano nangyari ko. Kasi may kutsilo na ako sa akin. Pag-pray na ako. Para maka-recover. Psychologically. Important yung personal advantage nito. Let me show you the bottom part, which is scary. Notice the 76% of elders. 76% of elders believe that their identity, yung pagkatao nila, nakuha nila sa core values ng magulang nila. Ain't that great? If you're an elder, 46 years old and above, kapiyon, you are who you are because of what you got from your core values. Ain't that awesome? That if you have bad core values, ganun din. No? Okay. If you were raised up by Adolf Hitler, Now, but what is the scary part to those of you who are fathers and mothers is this part here. 53% and 61%. Ito 53%, these are the youth of today. In other words, you're a young person, my kids, that boy, the interview there, oh, he is who he is. Only 53% of who he is nakuha niya sa amin. Where does he get the 47? Yung 47% influence ng mga anak ko. Saan nila mapapala yun? Society.
That's why this society is messed up. Kasi kinansin mo yung about 25%. No. As a result, and I'm in a hurry, this is the two prevailing belief systems today. One is secularism. Go ahead, pati kumpleto. Secularism. Secularism is crazy. Kasi secularism believes that kailangan ma-prove to be true by science in order for it to be true. So walang Bible, science. Talaga, Pastor? Yes, kita niya. Kung malinis ang puso mo niya, makikita niya. Halina, oh. Nag-reset sila. This is a survey done sa Christians. So, mga Christians po ito. Hindi po ito mga kung sino-sino lang. Christian families po ito. Christian youth, church-going people say, look what it says. To those who are 45 years old and below, they believe that 25% of them believe that it has to be scientific in order for it to be true. Second, a person's life is valuable only if society says valuable ka. 28% ng mga kabataan ngayon naniniwala na mahalaga lang ang buhay mo pag sinabi ng society mahalaga yung buhay mo. Kaya sino ba yung na-idolize natin? Sino ba yung na-idolize na marami nyo? Basketball players, artista. Look at the Filipino culture. We elect direct imbeciles into office. Tapos magreklamo tayo. Sino Filipino election? Puro artista. Tapos magkatahay, walang alam. May artista eh. Tama? Buti sana ako nagbabasa. So, alam mo si Senator Pacquiao, kahit ganun-ganun yun, may research team yun. I know that for a fact. And he's an avid reader. Sabi ko nga eh, kung nabibigyan ng pagkakataon mag-aral itong tao ito, yung ibis na mag-boxing, eh mataas na pinag-aral ito. Dahil ang hilig na magbasa. Basa ng basa ng basa. So, I'm not saying it's perfect, pero basa ng basa ng basa. No? Marami tayong mga in-elect ng mga tao sa posisyon, may taga-basa, tapos taga-explain. I know that for a fact, I'm to know school. So, meron ba yung taga-basa? Look how crazy that is! They believe that, no? Look at this. Meaning and purpose come from working hard and making as much possible money so that you can make the most out of life. Paano maganda yung buhay mo? So you can have an awesome life, mag-ipon ka na mag-ipon, mag-talim na mag-talim, kumita na kumita, work hard as much as you can so that you can make life better. 40% almost, 37%, ibig sabihin, apat sa bawat 10 bata. Ang paniwala nila, mag-imbak ka ng maraming pera, kumuha ng maraming gamit, pagyamanin mo ang sarili mo para maging matino ang buhay mo. Kaya messed up yung kabataan natin eh. You know why America is messed up economically? Kasi the people are messed up economically. They live in a false facade. Kaya yung mga kabag-anak natin na sa Amerika, hindi makapag-skip na isang araw na trabaho. Bakit ka, Pastor? Kasi they skip one day of work, they lose money. Baka batakin yung mga inutan nilang TV, kotse, lahat, kung ano-ano. They care. They're motivated by work. Don't judge the American culture. Kasi ang Filipino culture is the number one. Number one call center country in the world. If you work in a call center, know my personality. I love you, but I'm going to tell you the truth. What is your number one reason for leaving a job and going to another job? I remember listening to Tita Eden speak to a graduating class eons ago. She said, marami tayong mga tao na galing na nurse, pero nag-call center. Hindi na mag-practice yung trabaho, not even anywhere in the medical field. Sayang yung pinag-aral. Bakit? Kasi ang number one motivating factor is, ano no? Masakit sa pili. Satisfied naman yung trabaho mo, nami-meet naman yung bills mo, okay naman lahat, but you go for the other one. Why? Kasi, Tama. I just proved my statistic to be true. Tama? Okay, mag-alala. Sa mga pastoral, marami rin ganyan. Ito. Kaya I'm so proud of our pastors. And you know, Itong mga to are the most recruited pastors I've ever known in my life. They've been recruited to go to America, Australia, Canada, England. Kung school na lang, Africa, si Pastor Jones, papadala ko ng kulit eh. They've been recruited to just about every continent there is in the world, and every time they come to me and say, Pastor, may kumakausap sa akin, I said, if I pray mo, if God says go, pumunta ka, go. Well, of course, I've never been a believer personally. That God says do it, ipag-raise ko yung pera, kalma, pumunta ka, kasi kalma ko yung pagnanin. That's what I've always said. No? And they've always said, so far, you know, eh, dito ko pwede ng Panginoon eh. If that's what you say, okay, game, we're on. That's why I'm so proud of these guys, kasi their hearts are in the right place. And God has given them wives who think the same. You know? Think the same. Si Pastor Dudes, nung namatay si Hugh Hefner, yung salito, sa kanya pinakamahal kasi na-forma na eh. Binibigyan siya ng bathrobe kasi Hugh Hefner nakabathrobe yung parang tsaka may Mexicano. Yes. Pero yung Pastor Dudes, siya pinakamahal eh. Ayaw na niya. Napagami ng core values niya. No? Look at the last statistic that I'll jump into my day. Postmodernism, no one can know and obtain the meaning and purpose of life. 32% ng mga kabataan ngayon, 45 years old and below, naniniwala, hindi mo alaman kung ano yung purpose ng buhay. And I want to say, Pastor, I'm not one of them. Really? We'll determine my man. What is morally right and wrong depends on individuals' beliefs. Wow. Kasi we just kill people. Kaya meron tayong gobyerno, nakalag-gobyerno, pagpabor sa'yo, may kalabuhong ginagawa, gawa mo ng jacuzzi sa National Penitentiary, move away. Tama? Ipa-aircon mo at bigyan mo ng opisina yung mga biggest drug dealers in the country, look away. It's beneficial to you, right? And then we have a current government, ha? Huh? Pagka marunong mag-spelling ng drug, D-R-U-G, BAM! Patay ka na. Bakit? In-spelling ng drugs. Right? Kasi it depends on what you believe. If your beliefs offend someone or hurt someone, it's wrong. This is America. Mga Engot, mga Amerikano. Mga Engot, mga Amerikano. Lahat sila crying racism. Racism, racism, racism. Everybody's crying. I understand racism, is it? But in today's society, everybody's crying racism. Come on, give me a break. Get up! Tama? Get your butt off and go to work. You've been given a freedom to go to work. Go to work. Tama? What a crazy world we live in. Guess what, parents? That's the world of our kids. To those of you who have babies, and your baby, and you're heli-heliing them, that's the world. They will grow it. It's getting worse as we go along. No? Pastor, nothing that was in Jesus, I don't know. And as far as I'm concerned, I should not care right now. My job is to do the will of God who sends me. So, Pastor, what are you trying to say? What I'm trying to say is that your home is only as strong as the foundation it is built on. Ang tahanan mo ay kasing lakas lamang ng pundasyon kung saan mo tinaguyod ito. Tama? If your home is founded on truth, it will live on biblical truth. Kahit anong sabihin ng society, it won't matter. It might hurt them, it might confuse them, but at the end of the day, they will do right. The Bible says, train up a child. It means to always, all the time. Deuteronomy says, in all you do, ito kituro mo. Pastor, will kids who grow up in church and, you know, and Christians make mistakes? Yes, they will. And they will do the craziest things. But if you rear them right sa tamang values ng Panginoon, they will willfully know what's wrong and they know how to come back. Hindi po sapat na pagsimbahin ninyo ang mga anak nyo. Not anymore. Not when you have 6 days of cultural misinformation and you expect me and afterglow to correct the problem. Kaya ang dami natin ministries dito. Ang dami natin fellowships para ma-center kayo ulit. Mag-attend kayo ng mga fellowship, hindi lang dahil sa dapat kayo mag-attend, kundi para ma-center kayo ng tama. Because you immerse yourself every day in wrong teaching. Alright? Let me prove my point. If you work for a company, he who makes the most money for a company gets an award. Employee of the week, employee of the month. That's not necessarily true. Because if they work only to get money, it's still the wrong values. Sometimes I will stand outside of my office and my wife always sees me do that. Nakatayo ko outside of my office, parang sa second floor, balcony. And I'll just watch people. What do you watch for, Pastor? Kunyari, may janitor to, o may teacher to, yung bata, tatlo ng basura, hindi niya pinansin, strike ball ka sa akin. O kaya bigla kang nagwalis, kasi nakita ko lang ako sa taas, strike 35 ka sa akin. Kinakausap ko ba sila, Pastor? Hindi naman. Sometimes, I'll just go down to the second floor, pick up the trash, and throw it in the trash can. What's interesting is the moment I do that, lahat ng tao may tinasalam. Sir, ako na! Isang candy, mag-aagawa kayo. Kumahanap ko yung sarili ng candy. Akin na to. I watch. You see, your home is only as strong as the foundations built up. If you change the culture, you will change the climate. Psalm 127, verse 1. I'm just saying verse 1. Second. Unless the Lord builds the house, they labor in vain that built it. Unless the Lord keeps the city or guards the city, the watchman wakes up, is awake, but it's all in vain. What a powerful verse. You've always read that forever. This was actually a psalm written to Solomon. No, if you read the traditional translation, it says Psalm or Psalm of Solomon. In the Hebrew text, it says it's a psalm or song for Solomon. Si David to, tinuturuan niya yung anak niya. Malayo pa lang, mukhang may pagka-playboy niya. No? Alam natin doon, mga magulang na dito, basa mo anak mo, maliit pa lang. Tama? No? Sabi mo itong matang tandaan, the other day, we were having dinner with friends and they interviewed us about all our kids. Sabi niya, sino mo ba yung anak mo? Gusto mga boys mo. So we began to describe each one of them by their own character. No? And we ended up with Noah. Sabi namin, no, si Noah, pag-pray mo siya. Kailangan niya mag-pray. Yeah. Right? Alam natin yung Diyan niya magulang, basa niya anak niyo eh. Basa niya yung apo niyo, di ba? No, I know, being a grandparent like myself, lahat ng grandkids natin, genius, gifted, anak ni Einstein, also ni Hitler, yung mga brilliant daw, mga ganun. That's what most grandparents think, you know. But the truth of the matter is, we have a song by David singing it to Solomon, pinasulat niya, and he says to Solomon, what an intense verse 1, he says, Unless the Lord builds the house, those who build it, they labor in vain. If you're taking notes, the word in vain means hindi sabi yung wasted. It means they lay it in ruins. Wow. Desolate, ruin. Ibig sabihin, hindi na pwedeng gamitin. To destroy beyond repair. Have you ever had anything destroyed beyond repair? Tapos namin kaya ka. I remember when I first had my cell phone. Isang cellphone. Gusto ko yung cellphone. So, ginawa ko, binilihan ko ng guard sa gilid, yung rubber, whatever, na kapal-kapal, mahal-mahal yung guard. Tapos, binilagyan ko ng the best tempered glass I could find. Nilagyan ko, I mean, man, that thing was, in my eyes, indestructible. No? Yung cellphone yun, right? Until it fell. Nung nahulog, bababa ko naman, table, sa boom! It fell down to the floor. Sabi ko, it's okay. Hindi ko ba dyan ko, sorry. Bumper guard yan, 21st century technology, yung mga ganun ba? No problem. Pagdampos ko meron, basa! Grabe! It's okay. Kasi may tempered glass yan. The tempered glass eh. At 1,500 pesos tempered glass para. Hindi masisira yan. Guess what? Basa! No? So it's okay. Tempered glass yan. Nakabumper guard sa gilid, etc. Right! Basa ko yung salamin, buo yung casing, buo yung tempered glass. So yung protection pala, para sa tempered, hindi sa telepono. Saan na ba pinilihan ko ng tempered glass yung telepono? Tama?
Ibig sabihin, destroy beyond repair. But napalipay ko naman siya. I will only one. I waited about 2.5 years hanggang magmura. Yun. Kasi palit lahat eh. No? Palit lahat. It was destroyed beyond ruin. Interesting, kasi what your foundation in your home needs to be is only two. Dalawa lang in verse 1. The first one is, there must be an ongoing relationship with God. Notice what it says, unless the Lord. Dalawa. The word unless was used twice. In the another wording for it was something, kung hindi lang ang Panginoon. In simple English, if God does not build your house, if God is not the guard of your house, yun ang sinasabi dyan. Is that incredible? Sa mga tatay natin, is that what you do? You're building your house and then you're guarding your house? Tama? So I remember my brother, it was the first date of my pamangkin, no? And on her first date, the guy walks into the living room and my brother brings out all the guns and he's cleaning the guns. The shotgun, yung 45, yung 9mm, habang ano, and yung susundo, and he was gonna pick up my niece for a first date, and she was like, what, 18 or 19 already? She's cleaning the guns. No? So, sabi nung ano, building service, sabi na kuya ko, ano kuya ko, mama, mag-aanap po si Stoli, hindi ka paris ko, medyo intensive po. Si kuya, medyo mag-aanap po something. Sabi na kuya ko,
yes. What's your name, son?
My name is...
Where do you live? What's your social security number?
Kinuha lang natin information. No? No, si Pastor Wayne, Marine siya. He's a retired Marine. First thing to lang niya, sabi niya, son, I just want you to know, I have a gun, and I have a shovel, and I know how to use both. Sa mga merak na babae, that is a good. What's your name, son? Sabi ng kuya ko, bigay pa sabi niya, I'm Colonel Tika. Naging candle bigla.
I'm Colonel Tika, no?
Very good. Si Aaron, gumagawa na yung tower na walang hagdan. Tapos babatuhan yung pagkaya lang yung babae ko yung nagpapag, di makalap eh. As crazy as society is. Tama? Is that what you do? You build your house? That's your main motivation when you wake up in the morning. You have to go to work. Kahit pagod na pagod ka, grabe, babangon ka. Masakit na katawan, babangon ka. Nag-overtime ka. Tapos yung overtime, ano? Overtime, ano ba? Overtime. Tama, gabi na, natatrabaho ka pa. Iba sa inyo, aalis ng bansa. Iliwan mo yung pamilya mo, baka naman mo. They will be without their father or without their mother or both. And you work hard. You know? Tama, that's what you do, right? Right? I believe in working hard. You wake up in the morning, work hard. Titipilin mo bawat kaunti. Try to send your children to the best schools that you know. Tama, the best school that money can buy, you send them there. You buy them everything that you think they need to be successful. So at 9 months old, they have their own iPad. Lahat ng gadget na doon, lahat ng stuff na doon, and you try to build your house, and you build your house, and you build your house, and I'm here to tell you this morning, you can build your house as much as you can, but unless the Lord builds your house, you're ruining your house. That's what the Bible says. Pastor, that's not my intention. It doesn't matter your intentions. That's not my goal. That doesn't matter either. Good intentions, good plans fail when they are not ordained by God. And what it says is, unless God builds your house, you will destroy it. Unless the Lord, unless Jehovah God, Elohim, builds your house, you're going to destroy it. You're single? I have a simple advice to the singles here. Single, marrying age. Sabi ng anak ko, ha! That's true. 18 na ako. Marrying age mo ako. Marrying age. Singles who are here,
Ele é o homem secreto. Olha que eu tenho. Maguinho, chuchu, caiu. It's okay to be choosy.
Pastor, do mal é o first thing. Second thing. Third thing. Last thing. Pastor, yung ito na nalilinaw sa akin, bad trip na to. Ito patulang ko na.
Maging choosy kayo. Because it's not about your life. I am a firm believer, I'm a firm believer that when you become an adult, it's no longer about you. It becomes about your family and their future. No longer about you. Maging choosy kayo. Hindi si Atilus. Parang sampul di muna choosy pa rin. Pastor, sabi ni Apostle Paul, it is better to marry than to burn. That's true. But looking at some of your choices, mas mabuti mag-burn na lang. Just burn. Just burn. Anong tingin siya? Buti mo choice? Pili, pili, pili. Ay, hindi pwede yan. Ay, hindi pwede. Ay, hindi pwede. Kasi pastor, I'm a firm believer yung sabi sa Bible, if you love someone, set them free. Pagalawa mo sa lahat, wala sa Bible yun. We know how to set them free to make the right choice. And ibig sabihin na the right choice means that there's an ongoing relationship between you and God. That means you have a personal walk with God. I'm not saying that you have a religion. I'm saying if you remember a time in your life when you said, God, if you don't change my life, if I don't follow you, I will mess myself up. And beginning today, I will follow you and you alone in my spiritual walk. And because I follow you, I will trust you. Sa lahat ng gagawin ko, magtitiwala ako sa'yo. And when you do that, you can be called a Christian, not because you are Baptist or Bible or whatnot, but that you follow Christ. Hindi pwede pa atras. You see, godly homes must be built on godly materials. You can't make it godly. Pag mali, mali is just wrong. And regardless of how good it looks, have you ever seen something that looks good, tastes bad? No? May mga bagay na ganda tingnan, ang sarap at subo mo, anuhan pag ganyan. Exactly! You can't do that. You can't enter into relationships. You can't have bad culture in your home. And when you do it, you spit it out. You can't do that. It's going to cause damage every time. Your foundation needs to be an ongoing relationship with God. How do you know that, Pastor? Because it says in there, bless the Lord, builds the house. You know this building? It starts with the foundation, and then the main building, and then the roof, the hall, all those processes. Ang problema sa mga pamilya ngayon, pinubuo mo yung roof. You build the shelter of your home. No, with all your money, with all your goals, with all your education, and there's no foundation. That's why you're messed up. Yung mga binibili yung ginda. Puro pa pokey, puro pa cute, puro pa ganda. It's all shiny and cute and nice. But there's no foundation. It gets messed up. If you read Deuteronomy 6, the instruction is let God be on everything that you do. We try our best. I grew up with the idea before. I remember, see, my sister, yeah, genius, yeah, Kalinga. My brother, man, that guy's good, okay? Atiko, she finished cum laude, no? Datiko, my dad, you know, lahat ng Lord, nakuha niya, no? Ako, I graduated, praise the Lord. Yeah. I remember in elementary school, I got a line of seven math. I was terrible at math. Pero magaling ako sa science, pero walang sense yung math sa akin kasi walang relationship. Na parang I just Sabi sa back, sabi yung teacher, solve for X. Why? X for anything. Pag X for na, ayun mo na, X for na. Pag mo nang balikan, di ba? Basta yung tagal, bakit mo yung tagal? Kasi Pastor Good said, well, that is not necessarily true. You should always solve the X. Sabi ni Ate Mary na, mukha mo, ano ba? Ay, mukha mo, ano, tulis, kalimutan mo yung X mo. Huh? One day, I got, wow, 77. Masado naman, but 77 sa man. And I was like, tapos Filipino, oh my goodness, Filipino, 76. Kapal na pala ko. I was like, you know, wala naman kaming rule in my house na kailangan lahat, you know. And so, you know what I did? Binawa ko, grade 3. Galing ko eh. Yung 77, nilagyan mo ng ganun. In December. Galing, ha? Tapos, sabi ko ba? Maganda naman yung sura. Ginawa ko rin sa Pilipino. Ginawa ko rin. 86. No? Pinakita ko rin. Sabi na dati, oh, ano ka? Sipi mo, 87 ka sa ano? Sa matag, 86 ka sa Pilipino. Galing mo na. Okay lang dati, nag-work yung tutor natin. So, pinagbahan yung test. Pabalik mo sa teacher mo. Patay. Siyempre, alam yung teacher, di ba? I came home, just made the long story short. Obviously, I prayed the grade. And my dad just told me something. And in our house, and in our house, it's the same question today. Something, in our house, we never asked you to be an honor student. We never asked you to do this or do that. I just have one question for you. Ano yung dad? As grade 3, grade 2, sabi niya, did you do your best? Honestly, did you do your best? As in, talagang, you tried to answer and that's the best you could answer. And he said, don't answer. But if you say yes, then that grade is good enough for you. Next question. You think you can try harder next time? Of course, I don't know. Yes, diba? Yes, Dad. Okay. Together, we will try harder. Tapos na usapan. Done. That's the core values of education, Dad. That's it. Finish. Meron kasi hindi lang education sa bahay namin. Alam ko, maraming kabataan, gusto mo paalpun sa akin, gano'n. Okay, text, Pastor. Pwede po bang dunin ako sa bahay mo tumira? Kasi akala na magkula ba ako si Einstein? Yun pala ako si Weinstein, yung gumagawa ng piano. Akala na magkula ba ako si Da Vinci? Pero ako kasi maliksing, hindi po yung ano, mayor na dating gangster. Maliksing, hindi po ko Da Vinci. Pwede po bang pangko na lang sa inyo? Hindi niya pwede, puno na yung bahay namin. Mukha na kami buhay pag kumakain, may pila eh. Literal po yun. If you want your house to be the right foundation, have an ongoing relationship with God. And simple na formula, the second formula, and I'm done. The second formula says it this way, sabi niya, a right foundation must be a daily pursuit. Notice what it says. Unless the Lord builds the house, they labor in vain that build it. Nasayang. The second unless, unless the Lord guards, unless the Lord keeps, unless the Lord watches. Faith and followership should be the rule and standard, not an option in all things. You know, sinasabi, sabi, anak, so, David, you know, it's terrible that, made a lot of mistakes, but this one advice, tama si David, sabi niya, Solomon, you're the next guy, okay? Si Absalom, he's dead. You're next. And you're gonna establish a royal family, and you're gonna have this, Solomon, listen to me. Faith and followership of Jehovah God is the standard, not the option. Please don't make faith optional in your home. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1 to 6, faith is necessary to come to God. It's necessary in salvation. It's necessary in your everyday walk. When you make faith negotiable in your home, you ruin your family. Because often we only come to God, unfortunately, even the most faithful Christians will have the urgency to lumapit sa Panginoon, usually, pagkadulo na. Tama ba yun? destroyed, when things are messed up, we run to God. God, let my home. Right? Right? And that's why David was advising his son and saying, faith and followership should be the rule. Unless the Lord builds the foundation, everything is wasted. Teach your family to pursue God sa lahat ng bagay. It's time for us to be serious about building our home. It's time to break the culture. I am a Filipino by heart. Okay? I am American by accident. Nakaulang po na pinanganak ako sa Egypto. Sa Amerika. But then, as much as I love the Filipino culture, we have a lot of messed up cultures in the Philippines. How about this one? Bakit ang lalaki okay magluko, ang babae hindi? Bakit acceptable pag ang lalaki maraming shota, playboy? Pag ang babae, hindi ko nasasabihin sa lita. Pastor, are you saying dapat sa babae okay din ang what did you say sa akin? Sabi ko pa, yes! Bakit mo rin kasama ko ulit eh. Kasi step closer na sa basurahan. Oh, susundot lang ako kasi oh, wala ko ng kadalik ha. Men, mga patay. Yung cute na girl, yung parating mo yung text, kasi mo, kumain ka na, pero sabon yung mata lang. Always para bawa. Ingat! My God, ingat! Musta na? Nag-tag mo, musta na? How are you? Tanda-tanda mo lang, mahalo ka pa. Pag-ayos ka na. Men. Yung babae, na pinapormahan mo, kasi pastor yung babae na yun, she understands me. Naintindihan niya ako, you know why she understands you? Because she doesn't have to put up with you. Sorry, I will be a little bit risky. Kung sakal mo lang kayo ng tama nakikita, hindi kailangan ng misunderstanding. Kasi wala siyang pressure para labahan yung damit mo, gumawa ng baon mo, itindihin yung hininga mo sa umaga. Live with your craziness, live with your mood swings, your bad temper, hindi niya kailangan mabuhay sa loob nun eh. So, syempre, if all she has to do is say, ah, kamusta ka na ako? Talaga, how's your work? Oh, ito na mo ng life ko. You're so good and so talented. Oh, ang galing-galing mo. Hello, yung pala gusto mo eh. Mag-aaral ng cheerleading. Mag-hire ng cheerleader, mayaran sa bahay. Para pagpasok mo sa bahay, pagod ako ka pa-work, tapos, ha? Pagod ka, bad mood ka, yung misis mo na doon, pagod din, talagang ginagawa lahat to work, and you want the wife to be a cheerleader for you, papasok, you hire yourself a cheerleader para pagpasok mo sa bahay, pagod ka, woo! Hello, sir! How are you? Woo! Done! Mag-i-split pa yun, wow! Kasi pastor, she understands me and she has time for me. You know what? Gawin mo yung mga ibang trabaho kailangan niya gawin, she'll have time for you. And that yourself is a preview of the couple's retreat. And now all the wife says, "Get up, what's the trip? You gotta panalo tayo dito." Tama? Ikaw, Mark. Kami siya kaya-alus. Di ba kung hindi tubig, di ba kapansin nila? May proposal ba mamaya? Make it a standard. Unless the Lord guards. Guard talaga, guard. Keeps the city. The watchman. Ako yun. You mean to tell me, Pastor, ako, si Pastor James is the watchman of my home. Ako yung bantay sa bahay namin. Ako yung nakatindig sa baluwarte ng tahanan namin. All my efforts will be in vain unless there is a daily pursuit of God's will in our life. I'm not saying your family will be perfect. My family is a picture of imperfections. But if there's a daily pursuit after God, mistakes will happen. And it doesn't have to be a ruining. Nakakabalik. Kung yung pagkalubayan yung nakututulong sa napuntan, yun ang balik ba? Alam mo balik. If you are a young person, single, or bata pa kayo, you've made mistakes in your life, and you are in church today, pag-uwi mo sa bahay, yakapin mo yung pagulang mo. At magpasalamat ka, ma, na, salamat ko, na kahit ang kulit ko, nasa tama ako. If you are in church today, and you have a walk with God, pero wala kang parents na meron, I guarantee you, someone was a parent to you. Meron nag-mentor sa'yo, sa loob ng church. Pag yung tatay mo kahimik, alas gusto nyo praning, pag yung nanay mo kahimik, alas gusto nyo praning, you have no Christian influence in your home, and you're in church, someone mentored you. Thank God for them. Go text them, go write to them and say, salamat po. Kahit wala akong strong parental influence na andyan po. Some of you, your parent became this church. Itong church natin. That's why I love this church. You know? Kahit ganda, alaki yung adami na ba, casual pa natin. Nagbabatihan tayo ng happy birthday sa gitna ng program. Sa ibang church, bawal yun. Because it's not formal, you know? And what's crazy here is the word unless, I can bring back my verse, unless the Lord, no? Unless the Lord, and then the outcome is the same. Interesting. Why is that way? Okay. So, unless the Lord builds the house, they labor in vain. Unless the Lord keeps the city, the watchmen waketh, but in vain. Vain then. Same unless, ang outcome, vain, vain. Yung vain na yun is not just a simple, ay sayang. It's not a simple wasted, but as I said earlier, it was to be ruined. All your efforts to ensure and assure your family and their life will be gone and ruined. Pag hindi po tayo nag-umpisa ng bagong kultura sa ating mga bahay. Huwag niyo po basta utusan lang. Like I said last week, don't drive them, lead them. Turo mo. Bakit? Take time. Alam ko, ako ganun eh. Ako kasi I have a very strong sense of right and wrong. So sa akin, pag tama mo gawin, dapat ginagawa mo na yan. And I have to restrain myself sometimes or listen to my wife. Kasi kailangan yung paliwahan yan. Kasi hindi nila alam eh. It's a constant teaching of things. And I have to be reminded of that often, too often. Don't just drive them, lead them. Anak, kasi ganito yan. Anak, kasi ganito yan. Anak, kasi ganito yan. Anak, kasi ganito yan. No? Lalo pag wala kong anak na ang pangalan Ashton. Apo pinagsasabi ko, piyak ko may pakitin sa'yo ganyan. Gusto ko sabihin, anong nung high school ako, pag tingnan mo ako lang ganyan, nakabalik ka sa sahin. Yung pinagsasabi ko, sa tingnan ka na masama. Ano ginagawa niya? Kasi kailangan paliwanan. Ba't siya na-trouble? Bakit hindi tama? Kasi tingin niya tama yun. Ano kasi ganito yan? Ito, gato. Kasi anak, ganito. Ito ba? Mom? Yamahal sa rin ng Paul. Tsaka ito si Aki Luzmak na irritating! Kakainis! Grabe! No? But you can't explain. It must be a daily pursuit of right and wrong. The Leaning Tower of Pisa, I love that. The Leaning Tower of Pisa is an interesting piece of artwork. It's the most recognizable building, architectural building in the world. From the old times. No? That's my prayer. Lord, all my efforts will be wasted without you. Help me leave my home today. Bakit? Let me explain. explain to you kasi si Leaning Tower of Pisa, hindi siya intentionally leaning. No? The Leaning Tower of Pisa, if you learn the reasons why it was leaning, okay? Hindi, but first of all, hindi siya nag-iisa. There are many leaning towers where that is. Kasi these towers were built on marshlands in Tagalog, Putikan. No? But these towers signify, if you read history, it was built on plundered loot. Mga ninakaw. Kasi the people were looting other nations. And to say that, oh, galing namin, they built a tower. But they did not examine the soil. They were so crazy, so engrossed with pagpapasika that to show, how good I am, how excellent we are. They built these towers. Hindi nila alam, it was on sinking sand. Marshlands. Mataas ang water valleys sa ilalim. It was built on plunder loot. It was built on treacherous subsoil, marshlands, soil on the top, soft on the bottom. Hundreds and generations of wrong engineering. They could not connect. In fact, when Benito Mussolini, not the only you know who he is, the dictator of Italy, when Benito Mussolini was so proud, ayaw na ipaayos, kasi sabi niya, let it be the same. But it was every year, bumababa, and one day it's going to crash. Right now, they said, because of modern technology, the Leaning Tower of Pisa is stable for the next 100-150 years, sabi nila. No? But, wrong, isang earthquake lang o isang bad flood, that piece of marble will come crashing down. Years of, you know, bad engineering and a proud Italian dictator destroys the beautiful artwork. The Leaning Tower of Pisa is both a picture of excellence because of its design and also tragedy because of its motivations. Does that sound familiar to you? Sometimes we like to build on families, on excellence, beauty, skill, no? Galing, usay, connections, padrinos, tama? No? Yung mga ninong at ninang ng mga anak mo, no? Lolo ng auntie, ng pinsan, ng kapitbahay, ng dating presidente ng Pilipinas noong panahon, yun ang Magellan, yung mga ganun. Puno yung resume ng anak mo eh. You send them to the greatest schools that money can buy, spends hundreds and thousands, even millions of pesos, give them everything that they can. It's all sinking sand. And when the whole world looks at the Leaning Tower of your family, and your children, and your husband, and your wife, habang bumibilib tayo sa kanila, na ang galing-galing nila, hindi nila alam every year, it goes down. Now, there was one year in the Leaning Tower of Pisa a few years ago. No, it sunk literally in one year, 10 feet. 10 feet. Ganyan kalaki yung building. It's just sinking sand. Sinking sand. And I want to challenge you today. If you're a leader in your home, if you are a father in the home, if you are a mother in the home, if you're a grandparent in the home, if you are a child in the home, pero ikaw lang yung Christian sa pamilya mo, I challenge you to change the culture, to break the wrong cultures, to reteach your children. Pastor, kasi yung anak ko malaki na, it's okay. One of the greatest things you will learn as a leader of the home is to say one incredibly powerful two-worded statement. Talaga, oh, kayo mga tatay, listen to me, fathers. Learn this statement and you will revolutionize your home. Because it revolutionized my own home with my father. Ano yung pastor? I love you. See, malikas. I put the words in. Kali yun. Alam nyo ka, no? I'm sorry. O sige, Tagalog, three words. Mali ako doon. Pag ang tatay na paamin mo lang mali, pakinggan mo din ba tatay? Pag ang tatay, napaamin mo ng mali. Walang ano ah, walang kapit. kasipyo, walang kasi-kasi. Pagkatakay, napaamin mo ng mali, I promise you, that home will begin to turn the corner. And you're right. But you can say all you want, do all you want, gawin mo lahat ng pwede mong gawin, but until you make things right, you're always headed the wrong direction. Husbands, those two words are incredibly powerful. On a side note, mga misis, pag nag-apologize yung asawa nyo, huwag naman silang paglabas ng listahan ng lahat ng mga kaso sa buhay nila. What are you sorry for? Enumerate them. Darating din tayo dyan, but we're turning the corner. If you drive, did you know that the hardest turn in driving is the first inch? Did you know that? So, ano ba mali, no? When you're driving, the hardest turn is the first inch. But once you turn, it will lead into the turn. Fathers, I challenge you to break the culture, the wrong culture. If you were raised up in that culture in your home for hundreds of generations like this living power, destroy it today. Because it's not about you. It's about your family. And then you would pray, God, Lord, all my efforts will be wasted without you. Help me lead my family today. It must be found in our relationship with God. It must have a daily pursuit of God. That prayer today. This service won't save your family. This service this morning will not save your marriage. This service today will not undo your wrong. But God, what God? Make things right. Dear Father, we come before you this morning. The first inch is the hardest turn for a U-turn. And so, God, I pray today that you will challenge your people, you will challenge all of us today to come and say, God, I want to turn towards you. As I lead my family, help me be led by you. Habang ako po ay nagagabay na aking pamilya, gabayan mo ako, Panginoon. Ayoko pong masayang lahat ng papabala na ibinigay mo sa akin. I don't want to mess up all the blessings you made. If you've made mistakes, it's time to start over. No better time to start over than today. No better time to say, God, let me start over today. We start over today. Let me do right. If you're single, pray. Say, God, I will run as hard as I can to follow you, Lord. I will seek you on a daily basis. And you will bring the right person into my life. Good. Stop doing that. Dear Lord, we praise you today. Lord, if there's people here this morning and they're seeking, there's people here this morning and they need you in their life. I pray, God, today, nakausapin mo po sila, Panginoon, right now. Help them to say, Lord, yes, today, right now, please change my life. I want to follow you. Ngayong oras na ito, Panginoon, baguhin mo po ang buhay ko, gusto kong sumunod sa iyo. Ibahin ang kultura ng bahay ko. If you've been walking a daily pursuit with God and for some reason, nalisyakan kung saan napunta, you're in the middle of a disaster and the tower is about to fall, won't you say to God, Lord Jesus, beginning today, I understand that lahat ng efforts ko, Panginoon, masisira if I don't follow you. So please lead me today. Please lead me today. Please lead me today. Lord, I pray that you would do that. Pray, God, that you would guide us in that. Ikaw po, Panginoon, ang gumawa nito, Panginoon. Please, Panginoon. Please, Panginoon. In your great name we pray. Praising you. Praising you. Challenge us for today. Challenge the fathers and the mothers, children today. In your name we pray. Amen.